is it at least made people aware of how important it is to control those weeds, and on the other hand, how easy it can be just to control population, especially when you treat it while it's small.
Oh, this project definitely has been a benefit to the county in many ways, in providing employment, in the work that's being accomplished, and the county really appreciates the opportunity to have participated in this grant. The grant came through the U.S. Forest Service down to the state of Idaho Department of Agriculture, and then sub-granted on to Benewah County. Right now, we have 15 people working on these projects.
Our job is basically twofold. We go out mainly and identify and find noxious weeds, and we'll spray those and try to eliminate those as much as we can. And then our other job, reducing fuel, helping reduce fire danger, a lot of brush cutting and just get rid of the undergrowth that are in wooded areas. But yeah, just to help reduce the fire danger.
Well, it'll benefit the local landowners by reducing the amount of weeds that could be transported by wind or by vehicle, which I think vehicle is probably one of the main culprits of how the weeds get established in other areas. Yeah, we've used some biological control and we know that it can be effective. What we have found through it is, though, you need to have a substantial population of both a weed and the insect that you're going to distribute and give it time to work without any other impact that might reduce its effectiveness.
We really think that this year we can take that biological control to the next step. So we're monitoring the areas that we did last year. We're also looking for new areas. We'd love to get more involved with that.
A lot of people are really thankful when we come out and we'll go brush cutting and clear things out, and it makes everything look a lot better and eliminate all those pesky noxious weeds. So
they've been limbing the trees and thinning out the area and piling up the slash piles so that getting ready for disposal. And so all of this has been fantastic. They've done a great job and I appreciate it.
They're taller weeds so that they can be ladder fuel for a fire. So even though all of the weeds, all the noxious weeds that we target are a serious fuel hazard in August and September here, we see those weeds particularly as being in areas where they can create some major problems for landowners. So again, it's a great way for us to do more than just attack noxious weeds. We can do brush control in addition to the noxious weed control, and we're really eliminating two of the three primary ladder fuels for fires.
I think it's a good project. It just is working in a community that needs jobs, and we are actually putting out a product like taking care of people's weeds and educating, giving some people that have been in the workforce a new set of job skills and just working with the community. From what I've seen, it's very positive feedback it's just been a positive program for the whole area.
I think it was a success because people were trained and given an opportunity to have another source of income or livelihood. And I know it was a success because we've often have the desire to spray more, to control for fire hazard and noxious weed. And without the money to be available to cover for the cost of the pumps and the personnel to operate those, the project wouldn't have happened, the areas wouldn't have been sprayed. And so it was a success on all of those accounts.